Hello and welcome to Europhoria, a podcast where we look back on the great glam and garish of Eurovision past. And I'm joined, as ever, by the disarming Roland Bodman.
Hello, Isobel. How are you doing?
Yeah, well, thanks.
Good. A very exciting week.
It's a very exciting week.
Very exciting time in all our lives, really, next few weeks.
It's exciting but sad at the same time because then we have to wait again and then the waiting happens.
But you forgot that's why we've done the podcast, is that for us Eurovision is all year round.
Never
every
ends.
Single
that's,
week.
That's why we do this, of course. But as you mentioned, it's exciting times right now. So this week is actually going to be a slightly different format to normal, as will next week and as will the week after, actually, because it is bloody Eurovision coming out, so we can't really ignore that.
No,
not going to talk about past songs. We've got like current shit happening right now to deal with. So today we're going to spend the podcast listening to some of the semi-finalists, first batch.
Yay! I'm very excited. I've been building up to this, listening to all the songs, getting ready, making notes.
Good.
Working out who I like, who I don't.
Good.
Who I hate.
Got it. Good. Because I need you to be more judgy, mate. This is a judgy episode, right? I can't be the only judgy one.
My turn to be judgy.
Exactly. We're not going to be doing this alone, though. We're not going to be the only judgy ones.
No, we're not.
Got a little guest here holding onto a little pink Hello Kitty cushion. So he's been mentioned many times on the podcast before. So this week we are joined by the... so I've written down creative director of the upcoming Eurovision screening in Peckham at the Montague Arms, and stepsister of drag queen Portion of Fries will be hosting the evening. We're joined by the wonderful Benji Jeffrey. Hi, Benji.
Hiya. I feel like I'm like living in a dream. I'm so used to like being in the bath when I listen to the podcast, and like being here and hearing the music come in and like seeing your faces.
Would you have been more comfortable if we did it around a bath with you in it? Would that have been?
I think in future, if I'm going to do it again, I do need splashing water. Okay.
That's fine. We can deal with that. Yeah, we'll just start throwing water in your face.
That'd be great. Thank you.
Before we get underway, as always, and even more so as we have a special guest on the podcast, who would like a lovely glass of Rioja from Spain?
Yes, me.
Yay.
I've not been drinking. I have had a few drinks in the last week or so.
And it's outrageous, this one. Outrageous.
I think I deserve it. So I will have a glass of wine.
As you're on the podcast, you know, it's tradition.
You've got to celebrate the good times.
Is this a good time? We're yet to find out.
It's a time.
It's a time that's happening, at least.
It's a time to be alive.
That. Honestly, you're going to need that wine to get through some of these songs.
Yeah.
I'm so excited. Yeah, I was saying to Isobel, well, the thing is, the difference between me and Isobel are old.
We're old, dear friends. We've celebrated many a Eurovision together.
We have. And the difference between us, I think, is that you like to go through everything methodically and know every song and everything about it.
I really like to know the best songs on the night and to be singing along to them. Like, I like to have a song is a good song when I can sing along to it. And if on Eurovision night, there's a couple of songs that I can already sing along to. What are you doing, Roland? Just freaking away in the background.
Creakiest cork,
trying to get attention because we're talking about us for once. Right, give us some wine, mate. Go and do your popping.
I've been creaking enough throughout that whole conversation. Here we go. You ready?
You're going to spill. Ooh! That was a really good pop.
That was a very good pop. Here we go. Let's just do...
Wow. Oh,
there you go.
Oh, I need
Isobel,
this.
Pass that to Isobel there.
There you go, love.
Thanks, mate.
There you go.
So nice to be able to see it as well.
Oh, I know, yeah.
I sort of imagined that you didn't actually do it, you know, you just kind of...
I just had a button to press.
Or you had like a huge contraption where you were like, it's too dangerous to... You know, like on that time trumpet thing when they talk about the EastEnders.
In the Albert, where they have to film the glasses afterwards on a green screen. Yeah.
No, it's
cheers, guys.
Cheers.
So I'm presuming this week, I mean, I ain't got any news. Have you got any news? Should we just skip the news?
No.
The news is, it's fucking Eurovision in 2 weeks.
Rehearsals are underway. People are seeing things.
I wouldn't even sing the jingle. Well, there's no need. There's no news. Right. No. Moving on. Any other business?
We have some any other business, don't we?
We've got a fair bit of any other business, actually.
I've got some any other business.
Oh, bloody hell. Yeah.
What's your any other business?
Well, I mentioned this to you the other day, Izzo. So there's lots of like... throwback to conversation from last time. Roland, you claimed that you're allowed to enter a piece of music into Eurovision that doesn't have any singing on it.
Instrumental, yeah.
But that's not a song. A song, by definition, has singing on it. I actually haven't double-checked this. But I'm fairly sure that that's not possible, because that is a piece of music, or it's
No.
Yeah, a song.
I mean, I've not looked this up either, so I don't know.
Should I look it up now?
Well, this is the
look it up in time for the end of the podcast.
This is a issue with the definition of Eurovision, Eurovision's rules, then, because there have definitely been instrumental songs at Eurovision.
That's bullshit.
Well, take that with Jon Ola,
mate. I don't want to start a fight with him. He's a re-unk.
There's
Beef
been
cake.
Songs. Green Sleeves, that's a song.
A song, most broadly, is a single
broadly.
And often standalone work of music that is typically intended to be sung by the human voice with distinct
but is this
and fixed pitches.
The meaning of a song or the meaning of the Eurovision Song Contest entry?
The meaning of a song. I'm just being
right,
a pattern.
Okay. Right.
By the way, just so we know, I am going to write a song called The Meaning of Song.
Ooh.
Of course you are. That does not surprise me.
So, there we go. Okay. We've already started beef.
Good. Pedantry. We'll work out the meaning of this. Yeah. This is the good thing about podcast. Don't do the work yourself, just get other people to.
Send us an email.
Send us an email if you know whether or not this is legal in the Eurovision Song Contest.
Like,
moving on, we've got some emails now to get on to. So we've had a fair few emails this week.
That's exciting.
Newbies as well. So our first email says, Dear Isobel and Roland, note, a good portion of this was written weeks ago, but my effusive emotions remain the same despite the extreme laziness in sending.
Oh.
Greetings from Nebraska in North America.
Hey.
Had to make sure I got that continent in there.
Yeah.
I do want continent only, though. I will specify that. Again, guys, you keep getting this wrong. I don't care what country you're from. Continent only.
Continent only. That's
Jesus
all that
Christ.
Counts.
That's
We're just
all that
doing
counts.
Very
okay.
broad
but
strokes.
Thank you anyway. I wanted to pop in and say how happy I am to have found you both.
Oh,
like we were hiding. I listened to probably 12 of your episodes while travelling to and from a prospective and now definite PhD programme.
Fuck! Congratulations.
We've got such smart listeners.
We've got two prospective doctors.
Mm.
Europhoria, approved by doctors.
And I couldn't have asked for better travel companions. Oh, thanks, mate.
Aww.
I literally bawled while listening to Isobel's Sionny's friend story.
Oh, God.
And Roland, I would have given Devil in Disguise a very confident 6.
Right.
But it's no serious song.
Hey, fan of the serious song.
I love
okay.
that we can just all songs have to be defined in terms of Roland's writings now.
It's
it was a man o' man, but it was definitely not a United We Dance.
But that, you know, I told Isobel the other day that me and my friend Matt were having a conversation in my kitchen. We're like, if you listen to the podcast, he's like, yeah, well, I really like the man o' man one. I was like, well, I wasn't too sure about that. And I thought Isobel got this one. He just like stood like doing the washing up. Like,
oh
great.
My God. Well, yeah.
Talk of the town.
How lovely is that?
Yeah,
oh, this is,
I really appreciate
by the way,
that.
This is from Hunter in Nebraska.
Hunter.
Formerly from Kentucky, soon to be from Kentucky again, but then finally Texas.
Oh, wow. Moving around. Dr. Hunter. Hunter's
again,
a great name
that's
for
why
a
we just need continent. North America. Fine.
Dr. Hunter.
Dr. Hunter, yeah. Oh, and also, you know, we're talking about magic.
Yeah.
Magic in Eurovision.
Oh, shit, yeah.
So there was Reggie emailed us to say about Croatia's, which
yeah.
was crap.
Yeah.
Awful. The guy's creepy. Just keeps touching her legs. So Hunter says, P.S., while Croatia's magic is shit,
yeah,
you're right there, Hunter. Yeah. Belgium's entry, Abracadabra by Fabian at Junior Eurovision 2012 is brilliant. And Hunter is not wrong, right? There's Fabian on stage with these two dancing girls, and the dancing girls do magic and make the band members appear.
No, that's
phenomenal.
That is genius.
Children.
One.
We the tiny.
Oh, lovely.
Our old friend Chance from Brooklyn also emailed us on the subject of magic.
Oh
so
my God,
thanks very much.
It's been a
ask
hot
enough
topic.
Times, it gets sent in.
Oh, he should be a magician. Chance the magician.
Chance. We love Chance. Yum. Yeah. Last year, Jury from Estonia did a card trick, which I remembered but then forgot because it was shit. He just did one
card trick.
But he just made a card disappear then threw it into the audience. That's one. That's not
on
really.
On a massive stage.
Yeah,
it's not
that.
Such a poor effort, yeah. And Chance says, and in 2011, Geta, also from Estonia, Estonians love magic, did some sort of trick during Rockefeller Street, which I rewatched today. And yeah, hers was better. She had like she had a silk scarf and then turned it into a cane.
Ooh.
That looked pretty great. That did look like magic.
Yeah.
But that was it. I want more magic. I want a whole... This is why. Well, watch the one that was for Fabian from...
Abracadabra.
The junior one. It's...
All magic.
All magic. Yeah. Loads of magic. Yeah. I impressed... And like kids doing magic too.
Yeah.
But it needs to be bad magic. I think like it'd be really good to have a song about like something along the lines of, oh, you know, we could be together, but that's not the way things are happening or something like that. And really crap magic that goes... When
Tommy Cooper magic.
Tommy Cooper magic. Like
oh, yeah,
good magic
that
looks like bad magic.
Yeah.
That's the name of a song for you.
Yeah, it's catchy. I think it's great.
It works. Yeah. I think it'd be big.
We've also heard from our one man unpaid marketing division, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
Who has spoken very kindly of our podcast on numerous occasions. So he says, hi, Roland and Isobel. I've listened to every podcast and loved every single one. And this is the first time I've emailed, although I don't think it is. I'm pretty sure Steve emailed before.
He tweeted before.
That's fine. Yeah. He did say, I hope I have music playing in the background right now. I'm afraid that is reserved only for the Reverend. he's a man of God. Like, respect that, please.
Yeah, and potentially if we get the insider back, who I have been having words with by a pool in some foreign client.
Well, I want some more gossip soon. I thought I'd let you know that I'll be going to the final in Kiev, so look out for my tweets from the show. Also be taking a trip to Pripyat, which is the deserted Chernobyl town.
Ukraine. Be careful.
You can't get more extreme differences than that, can you?
No.
You
cannot. Although some of the performances are pretty much like a wasteland. So
They are a disaster. And finally, we also had a very in-depth email from Lynn. So apologies for not reading it all out, Lynn, but I will reply if I haven't, by the time this comes out, I will do in full. Lynn says, hi guys, first of all, sorry for not being Swedish.
Oh.
I feel like you're so in love with Sweden that getting an email from their neighbour is like William asking Daisy to go to the festival.
What? I'm going to use that, whatever that is.
Lynn, I think that's lost in translation. That's my favourite phrase, but I have no idea what
William
it means.
Getting an email from their neighbour is like William
asking Daisy to go to the festival. And also, you make reference to this, Lynn. You don't actually say where you're from,
no.
mate. So I think you're from Finland.
It did make
me chuckle. That's the best opener to any.
Oh my God. I'm going to use that for sure.
Yeah, great. I found your podcast 2 weeks ago and I've just finished the 14th episode, Festival Fun, and decided that this was time to write in.
Yeah.
Lynn then writes in brackets, I'm not going to comment on the song. Good for you.
Lynn's not saying, I listened to 12 episodes, got to Festival Fun, and I'm not listening to anymore.
I gave up after that. My mornings now consist of walking to work while I listen to you, and that pop and cheer sound from the wine is a miracle cure for bad mornings. So please, never buy the screw cork again.
Oh, okay. I've been told. We did a good pop today, so hopefully your morning is going very
lovely
well. Enjoy your walk to work, Lynn.
Lynn's great. Lynn gets very soppy actually about crying and stuff.
Not in a sad way.
I mean, like, to relax like our podcast. Lynn then finishes her email by saying, I hope the future will send you lots of horrible songs. Thank you so much. I want some horrible songs.
Oh, yeah, we love horrible songs.
Keep up the super work. The podcast is just what I need as I warm up to the 13th and beyond.
Hey.
Thanks, Lynn.
Oh, well, I hope you'll listen to this before Eurovision, or even if you listen to it afterwards, it's fine too. But, yeah, thanks, Lynn.
Cheers, Lynn. You're my favourite one.
What a whole bunch of lovely emails.
Great emails, right?
Yeah, really helpful, really insightful.
And I will email back. If I haven't already, I will email you back because some of these have talked about too much stuff that I can't talk about.
Yeah, if you'd like to email us and maybe either get mentioned on the podcast and get Isobel replying to you or whatever, you can do that at the email address europhoriapodcast@gmail.com.
You can tweet us as well on Twitter. We are @EurophoriaCast because we couldn't fit the word podcast.
Yeah. there we go. Thank you for your emails. That was lovely. I feel warm inside.
Good. Me too, but I think it's the red wine.
Yeah.
Now, what we're going to do is we are going to go through the semi-finalists and semi-final one.
Some of the semi-finalists.
Some of them, not all of them. Some are duffers, so we're not going to talk about them. But we're going to play little clips. Benji hasn't seen them. Maybe there's a handful that I've forced you to watch. But
I've seen one or two.
Yeah. And then we're going to have a little natter about them.
Yeah.
We're going to go in order. We're also going to cover some of the top six.
We've split the top six, the big six.
We've split them in half. We're going to do three this week, three next week. We're going to start, we're going to go in the order of the evening as well.
Yeah.
So we are starting off with a man we've discussed many times before. Because apart from being a complete and utter babe, Dreamboat Heartthrob, just wonderful man. The song is as catchy as a cold sore. And
ew.
The staging is unbelievably cool. So now we're going to have a quick listen and a quick watch to Robin Bengtsson with I Can't Go On. This is Sweden's entry. I can't go on.
Beautiful.
Yeah. Oh.
So I mean, as I said just then, we're watching it. I genuinely think I'm going to get so excited in the evening, I'm just going to strip buck naked because it's too sexy.
If you haven't booked your tickets yet.
That's a reason to get your refund.
No, I mean, it's for me, that has everything a Eurovision song should have. So it's a super catchy tune, great looking singer, and like a really, really good concept with the walking.
Incredible
like,
staging.
The performance staging is great. Like, it's going to be up there. It could win. It could do great.
I think it should be in Sweden every other year.
Oh,
so it probably
no,
should
because
win.
It really should. It really it should be. Just the more reasons to see Petra.
Yeah.
Just they do it best. We know they do it best better than everyone else.
We just but, need I mean, to see Petra every 2 years.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Yon Ola, put that in the rules, please. Everyone sees Petra every 2 years.
Even if you just roll her out, like, halfway through the contest.
Just do wherever it's being held. So it's first in the runnings at semi-finals, which normally this kind of thing makes a difference. Not, however, when it's Sweden and it's that song.
No.
This is a shoo-in to get through to the final. It's a shoo-in to come in the top five, I would say. He's just... he does things to my loins.
The first thing I think when I see his face is that he would look very good in a production of Cats.
Wow.
He does have a cat face.
He has a cat face, and I think he would look good with all that makeup on and, like, you know, kind of doing the Mr. Mistopheles.
To me, it looks like he could be a banker from The Wolf of Wall Street or something like that. Like, he's got that real kind of... ego vibe about him, doesn't
it? Oh yeah, it's like, all about ego. Yeah. That whole song is all about ego, yeah. Which is why it's so great.
Yeah,
but there's nothing. It's not trying to pretend it's not. No. All those ridiculous. Like I cannot watch that without laughing out loud because it's so. It knows it's stupid. It knows it's ridiculous. It knows it's arrogant. Like it oozes arrogance.
And he's a proper pop star. If I saw him on the street, I'd think. Yeah, so
yeah, exactly.
But on stage, on a thing.
Perfect.
But less clothing.
So you want when they undo their jackets,
I want nipple.
Yeah, nipple.
Nip on shoe.
Yeah, that's
at least one.
Well, it's not too late. It's not too late, Robin. If you're listening,
one between the five of them.
Just
get rid of the polo polo jumpers.
Yeah, and then we'll just see
they're the turtleneck, aren't they? Not polo.
That's what I mean.
Yeah.
Right. So next song is Tamara. Can you pronounce her surname?
Gasha Leshilids. No.
Good for you.
No, I can't.
So this is Georgia. With Tamara, and her song.
Tamara, to go and do the song.
It's Tamara. Got, it's can weird. You down shops? I need to get another packet of fags.
She's got two names. She either goes under Taco or Tamara. And I think
Taco.
She's performed under. So for the national final, she performed under Taco, and then for Eurovision, she's changed her name to Tamara.
Tamara.
Yeah. Mm. Neither are great.
Stick with Taco. Taco. So this is Tamara with Keep the Faith.
About 12 songs in one. Like, where's the verse? I mean, it doesn't have to be verse chorus, obviously.
Well, we did jump in, but I like that.
It's a great song. It sounds like a Bond track, except not as good a one as Conchita did.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Which is a dud on that part.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. She is beautiful. And I want to maybe be her when I grow up. Because when you watch the actual live version of it, she has this unbelievable gold sequin dress on, this big curly hair. Yeah. She's an absolute siren.
Yeah.
But then they ruin it with the staging. So in the background, they have this video montage of atrocities from across the world happening.
Jesus
which
Christ,
I'm not saying let's... Leave politics that Eurovision, leave all that. No, obviously not. We discuss this every single week. But there's a way that you can do it without just ramming it in someone's throat with like videos. So Jamala's last year was all about, it was about war crimes and death and devastation.
Yeah. And you got that.
And you got it, but it was beautiful. And it was done in a way that wasn't just video images of ISIS in the background. It was just like, I'm not even exaggerating. No. There are videos.
And also, like, when you're wearing a sequin dress and you look like you're about to go out for a party, like in some club somewhere,
clubbing in it. She is standing at the top of some stairs in a beautiful palatial, like, concert hall while a man runs from the bottom to profess his love for her.
Like that Nicole Kidman advert where she, like, runs into a bed and, like,
But regardless, there's a slight contradiction there between seeing war crimes and then seeing her looking fabulous.
She could have, if they'd just done it very simple staging, like with Conchita, she's going to get through the semi-finals. She's going to do very well in the final.
Or if you're going to go down the war crime vibe, go down some sort of like Les Miserables on the barricades.
If you're going to go down the war crime vibe, guys, here's some top tips.
Number five. Fifth Harmony had that whole kind of barricade thing in their video. Yeah, that's a good vibe. Crime vibe.
She's fantastic. The song's going to get through the semis, but... Ooh. The staging, for me, you're just pushing it too much. But you know, like with the UK You Decide, with the one that was, put down your weapons, put down your weapons. Everyone gets it. You're not being subtle about this, mate. You're trying to push through here. Same thing. There's no subtlety behind it.
No. But also, I think a big ballad, a big Bond ballad, wait 10 years.
Yeah, it's been
like,
done.
Too
been
soon.
Done.
Conchita is such a like big winner.
Yeah.
Like EDM banger could win every year.
Yeah.
Yeah, but ballad.
The Bond theme is a very distinct thing, that was the first time I listened to it. I was like, oh, it's like Conchita's.
Yeah.
Which it's a good, like you say, it's a good song. It's like Conchita's. It won't win because it's Conchita's done it.
But well done, Taco.
She's got
good
an amazing
for you,
voice,
Tamara.
Great voice, Taco Tamara.
So third up in our lineup is written as the Australian George Shelley.
Because
he definitely is. So this is Don't Come Easy by Isaiah. But it never works, no, it never lasts, no. In my mind, I gotta get things right. Take it slow before I jump this time. No, it don't come easy. No, it don't come cheap. Been burned too many times to love easily. Don't mistake me. My love runs deep, but it don't come easy. It don't come cheap. No, not with me. Right, so we've cut that. Cutting that off after about 20 seconds because everyone was bored shitless. Australia really don't want to fucking win this year, do they?
After Dammy Im from last year, and I know you didn't like
I don't like her. I like the song. I don't like her. Like, that song was fantastic.
Yeah.
But he's not only is that dull as dishwater as it is, I've seen a live version of it and I wanted to kill myself. It's unbelievably tedious. He has no absolutely... Like, he's got wonderful... Brooke Shield eyebrows, but no charisma. And eyebrows do not make up for charisma.
No. And for like a hot second, I was like, oh, he's cute as hell. And then like the more you pan out, the more you see the hair, he turns to the front, you know, it just wasn't quite working out. And he's watched too many music videos and how they do things, but not actually watched himself in the mirror.
Yeah.
Because, you know, the kind of like the squinting of the eye, it wasn't convincing.
Right. I mean, they'll
Give me the truth inside your soul.
They'll do
Isaiah.
Well for because they're Australia, but they don't deserve to.
They'll get to the final.
They'll get through to the final, but they don't. But honestly, Australia, I hope you're listening hard here. You do not deserve to be there.
Anyway, Australia, sorry.
Moving on, Isaiah,
bye.
You suck. Next on the list, next up on the evening, will be Lindita from Albania with the song World. We're not going to play this one worth it.
We're saying she's not getting through to
the final. What a great name, though, Lindita.
It's Albania's go-to style, which they've done definitely for the last 4 years, I would say, and numerous times in the
genealogy.
Past. Very beautiful woman with a very blam song. It's nothing new. It's nothing new to Eurovision. Nothing else to say. Move on.
So what's her name again? Lindita.
Lindita.
Was it Lindita?
Lindita.
Lindita.
Lindita and Tamara are going to be having a great
That's
time.
What my firstborn will be called.
And up next, we've got Blanche.
Like Blanche from Coronation Street. I had a goldfish called Blanche.
I always imagine Blanche as being sort of one of the faded elites from New York in the sort of fit, like Blanche, ham.
Oh, like Golden Girls.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I think of Blanche from Corre. Skirt no bigger than a belt, far too much eyeliner, and roots as dark as a soul.
So Blanche is from Belgium.
Yeah.
With the song City Lights. So we're going to play a little bit of this now.
Big City Lights.
Here we go.
All alone in the danger zone. Are you ready to take my hand? All alone in the same town. Are we going to lose it all? Let's put some light into our lives, but keep the storm that's in your eyes. Let's put some light into
So there we go.
That's a very strong Hot Chip album track.
Isn't it
great? Yeah.
I'm really into it.
Yeah.
However, not a Eurovision song.
No.
Not a Eurovision song.
I have already listened to it many times, just potting around the house, yeah. doing a bit of work yeah. on my computer. Great song.
Mm.
Not going to do it well at Eurovision, though. I wouldn't be surprised if that didn't get through the semis.
It'll do... Oh, really? Wow. Yeah. That's...
It's not Eurovision.
No,
and it's not necessarily that bad songs don't get through. Bad songs get through all the time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
It's songs that the Eurovision crowd aren't into.
This song has a lot of integrity to it. And integrity doesn't win you prizes.
Sorry. You like, say seriously. This song has a lot of integrity.
It does. It's like Aminata from 2 years ago.
I love that song. I listen to that all the time. That got through to the finals. But yeah, it didn't do as well as it should have done, even though it's beautiful. But it wasn't a Eurovision track.
But also, I'm not saying this in a kind of like, women should wear more, because it could come across like I'm saying that women should wear more slap or something like that. But she needs a better stylist and something else happening, because the hair was a bit lank.
Was
like,
she
was wearing makeup, but it looked like she just had like a plain slap of foundation and nothing on the eyes.
Yeah, I think her overall style is very sort of like controlled. It's very like Belgian and sort of Germanic in a way. Yeah, so it's a
but
good
you know
song.
What? I agree with what you're saying there, because that's actually one of the notes that I put, was that they need, for this to be remembered on the night, they're going to need really good staging.
Yeah.
Because at the moment, this is going to get lost in the crowd of everything else.
Oh, do you know what she could do? A bit of parkour.
Oh God!
I think I would
immediately hate anyone that did parkour.
I wouldn't mind the makeup if she was doing parkour.
Okay,
let's move on.
Now we're going to talk about the man with the hair whip that would rival Willow Smith's. The absolutely sexual Slav Glow from Montenegro with Space.
The spaceship is ready to blow. Drunk in love, I'm gonna explode. Be my Bonnie, we'll mix and match with Clyde. Let's explore this galaxy of stars. Let's explore this galaxy of stars. I have my suit on, no need to worry. Give me your body, let's write a story. I'm body language.
So fucking good. That is not only one of my favourite entries from this year. I think I would go as far as to say that is one of my all-time favourite Eurovision entries.
So it's strong.
It's unbelievable.
He'd better be wearing big heels on the night as well.
Oh my God, yeah, big old platform boots.
I think I've seen pictures of rehearsal. I don't think we need to worry.
And he's going
to
be topless.
Yeah, and from the looks of it, it is mainly him just walking about stage whipping his hair, which is all we want.
Yes.
That is exactly what Eurovision is about. It is camp, it's ridiculous.
Why don't...
It's funny, it's like...
It's so sexual. There are some
wet dreams in the second line.
I was wondering, do you think he knows what wet dreams are? Or was
he
just
does.
Like, oh, I've been sweating
it's
a lot.
So very goes. Sexual.
I got the lyrics up. I'm just going to go through a few. So obviously there's a line, wet dreams, wild nightmares, I surrender. come into me from within. I mean, it's not, the spaceship is ready to blow. Drunk in love, I'm going to explode.
I might explode right now.
Oh, Jesus. Put a towel down. I have my suit on, no need to worry. Give me your body, let's write a story.
Delicious.
I mean, it's just, it's filth, really, but we love it.
It's filth. It sounds like it could that could be an early noughties George Michael track.
It could.
Yes.
Yeah, it's
and
very
I'm
strong.
Quite sad that George hasn't been alive around to hear it.
I know. You first found this like weeks ago and was just like, he's amazing.
Yeah.
But it's a great song as well.
But hold up for a second. One thing that I think it might be lacking, thinking back, is his voice as strong as Jamala, Dana?
I don't think it needs to be.
It doesn't need to be on a song like that.
Yeah.
Okay. He's not doing a Jamala song. He's not doing a Conchita song.
Have we ever had a singer that weak?
Yeah.
When?
Oh god. When? Yeah.
Oh my
yeah.
god.
Who?
So we did the story. It was, I think it was 2000. I mean, around that time, 2000 to 2004 was very weak. Like it was a very weak.
I think I block out Eurovision entries that I don't like.
Yeah. Isobel, though, I'm worried because this is your favorite. I am worried that this is going to slip through the cracks and not make it to the final.
Nah.
I would tend to agree with Roland on this.
We
I think
love it. And
it's not going to win. No. I don't even think it's going to get on the left-hand side of the board at the finals because I think en masse, the world is stupid.
Yeah.
People are stupid and they make the wrong decisions. But it will get through to the finals.
Okay.
We'll get to listen to it twice and have a great time.
Okay.
Yeah. And maybe one of his nipples is pierced. I don't know, but we'll have a see. We'll have a look.
I hope desperately that it will. I think
that one of his nipples is pierced.
Oh, I can't wait to see his life size whipping that hair around.
I know,
seriously,
right?
it's something else.
So
anyway,
exciting.
Who do you fancy more, him or Robin?
Oh,
Slavko.
You fancy Slavko more?
Yeah,
Slavko. I would fancy more on the streets.
Oh, okay, yeah. Robin, like I said, he does things internally that I can't control in my body.
I wouldn't want to go out with Robin because he's an arsehole.
No, he'd treat you like shit.
Yeah,
but
no,
you'd like, you take him home from a cocktail party and have a wonderful night of passion.
Oh, yeah.
And then never speak to him again. Yeah. So, next song up, we're not going to listen to either. So this is a bit of a contentious issue.
Well,
not really, but point of discussion anyway. So the next song up in the list is Norma John with Blackbird from Finland. So I left this one out and my notes on it literally just say dull, forgot it as soon as it finished. Because it is very dull. It didn't go anywhere, nothing happened with it. I think it'll be lucky to make it through the semis.
Yeah.
Then Roland, when I mentioned it, was like, oh no, this is
your favorite.
No, it is. Pitt is a favourite, though.
It's potentially...
they always pitch shit, though, don't they?
Maybe it's not as favourite as I thought it was. Like,
oh, good,
I've been looking at Reddit and people have been saying they like it. It's 25 to 1, which is sort of just like...
she looks pretty.
One of the middle ones.
I mean, it's from Finland. The reason it's up so high is because it's from Finland.
Yeah.
And all that Scandinavian bloc vote for each other, so they always get through. They always do reasonably well.
Yeah.
It's a poor song.
Is that true? I seem to remember last year we were surprised by the lack of support within the Scandinavian.
Well, Norway never really do that. That well, really.
No way, Norway.
The old phrase, the old saying goes.
Anyway, we said we were going to skip Finland, but we spent quite a long time talking about them, so we move on. Shall we move on?
Next song up in the list is Azerbaijan,
which I
had a bit of mention of earlier, which is Dihaj with Skeletons.
I'm a skeleton.
Now, for me, where Belgium sounded like a Hot Chip album track not right for Eurovision, this is doing the right thing, which is sounding contemporary, having that feel, but still having that European pop edge.
That is exactly what I've put down.
Have you?
I wrote, this is how you do something current within a Eurovision context.
Yeah, I think you're
that
right.
That is a modern Eurovision track. I think it's going to do, it'll get through the semis. I think it'll probably get on left side of the board. I don't think it's a winner.
No.
But good for you.
Well done.
Azerbaijan.
Yeah. I heard about her, the most I heard about her was from an interview I read where she described herself as an alternative artist who set up an electronic music collective called Dihaj, which is what she's performing under. Mm-hmm. And she sounded a bit, the sound has been described
as... sounded a bit wanky.
Yeah, the sound has been described
as... stop talking.
It's been described as experimental doom pop. Which sounds wanky, but it's a good song, so fair enough. And she studied contemporary music performance in London.
Yeah, just don't let her do any
in
interviews.
So,
that's why she's wanky.
Where did she
today? She's an artist in London.
I don't know where. In London.
London. She came and did a 2-week taster course at like Kingston or something like that.
At the Institute of Contemporary Music Performance. That's just something that someone set up in a back alley.
Bullshit.
That's not a real place.
That's
actually,
in like zone 12.
I actually heard that via my online university.
It's not a bad idea. It's a good song.
Yeah, good song. Yeah. Really into it.
But
I'd
she shouldn't
to that.
Talk.
She should stop interviewing them.
Can I get a wine?
Are you going to do a second pop?
You are go. Oh
for,
my God.
For
So,
for Lynn.
First time this has ever happened
so
on the podcast. We're doing a second popping off of a bottle of wine.
And is it dedicated to Lynn? Was it Lynn?
Lynn.
Didn't Lynn send you an
Lynn
email saying
pop.
Oh, Lynn, you love the poppy, don't you?
She might have arrived at work by now and she'll have a second pop, a bonus
second,
pop.
Should second we, pop for you, Lynn.
Here, I'll start unscrewing it whilst we watch the next one.
Okay.
Okay. You know what's next, Roland?
Oh.
This is Salvador Sobral with Amar Pelos Tua.
Talvez devagarinho possas voltar a aprender. Que me voltes a querer. Eu sei que não se ama sozinho.
Oh, I love him.
How can you not? My heart fucking just bleeds every time I see him.
And also, like, so many things are good and clever about this. Like, I think the great thing is that it's giving a... This is getting really emotional. It's great that we're giving a platform to him. But actually, I think it's a very clever marketing tool everyone else around him, which is that, you know, for example, Belgium, like I was a bit funny about her look. Was it Belgium? But like, he's comfortably shonky and wonky.
Yeah.
Mm. Whereas she looked uncomfortably...
Restrained.
He looks like comfortably shonky and wonky. Second of all, if you're going to sing in your native language, it's got to be a song like that.
Yeah.
Like Edith Piaf. Don't know what she's singing about, but I know it's beautiful.
Yeah, it is. That is. We said, like, that's a song you'd hear in like a Parisian like cafe.
It should be in the background of an Audrey Hepburn film.
It
reminds you of nostalgia for things that you're not even old enough to be nostalgic about. Like, I'm nostalgic about the old times.
Yeah,
hearing Salvador sing, and it was written and composed by his sister.
Oh,
so
my
proper
god!
They'd
better
gorgeous.
Not. They'd better let him dress like that on stage.
I think
if they put
will.
Him in a smart suit.
But we've
or
been
something
discussing
like
this.
That.
He's not well, so and I really worry that he's not going to be able to perform.
He's missing the first. He's missing the rehearsals. Because he's having, I think it's heart surgery from what I've read online. And that's like serious.
What's his name?
Salvador.
You probably know better than I do, Roland. I might be wrong here. But isn't it quite rare that the favourite actually wins?
Yeah, generally there's always like two or three favourites. So sometimes one of them wins. But generally, the favourite doesn't win.
Because Conchita, it was assumed that homophobia would mean she wouldn't win.
Yeah.
Like Ukraine weren't the favorite.
No, not at all. Russia, they were the underdog.
So the great thing about Eurovision is that there's always hope.
Oh, don't! Because I've got always going to have hope that Salvador will meet me and fall in love with me.
I might put a bet on Salvador. I think I've got faith in the world.
Because he's really charismatic. I was almost thinking like
a little weirdo.
Yeah, it's almost like he looks a bit like it was like Jared Leto playing like a weird role in a movie that he's got. Like he's got a kind of he's got a good looking face.
Oh yeah, he's a babe.
His movements.
I've watched so many of his videos online performances. He's a very beautiful like jazz singer, and he's gorgeous. Yeah.
And he's got the opposite thing that I find annoying about Devendra Banhart. You know, like Devendra Banhart is a bit like, you're playing up to this role and you're a bit over. Whereas it doesn't seem like he's playing up.
No,
this is
just a bit
him.
Weird. Yeah. He's just a bit odd.
Oh my god, I love Salvador.
On that note,
wine. Pop.
Second pop
to Lynn.
Hey!
Cheers to you, Lynn.
This is a good one.
Thanks, love.
And Daisy and William.
So, we've got a couple that we're going to skip now.
Yeah.
Okay. So, up next in the lineup after Portugal, I mean, he's going to be remembered for a while. That's maybe why they put some duff ones after him.
Yeah.
Firstly is Greece, which with This Is Love by Demi. Dullard. There's not much more I can say about it. Boring.
Yeah. There's enough Demis in this world. We don't need more.
I love a Lovato.
I love them all.
Oh!
I'm more a fan of Lovato. I was just trying to play the game.
nothing more to say about that. After Greece, there comes Poland with Flashlight. by Kasia Muzz. So you like this one, Roland? I'm not interested. Boring.
It's a dancey song.
It's better than some of the other ones, but it's nothing of note.
It's got potential to make it through to the final, but like you say, it's nothing of note, so pass over it.
Precisely.
Good luck to Poland. It's a dancey song.
Good luck to you all.
Good luck to Marseille.
We're equal opportunity people here. Good luck to you.
Yeah.
But up after Poland is one that I am very excited about, which is Moldova. So Moldova's song is called Hey Mama by the Sunstroke Project.
Ooh.
Or as I like to call them, Team Crazy Legs, as you will see right now.
Mama, don't be so down. All that keeps going round and round. Mama, mama, don't be so mad. If you knew me, you'd be surprised. Mama, mama, don't be so mad. She'll be back home till sunrise.
Love that one.
Yeah.
I love Moldova.
Yeah, I'm very happy with that.
Great.
Like, you look shocked with how good it was.
Great. But one thing, what I would do if I was creative director of this performance was I would give the women mirrors and I would make them have one leg out. So they did, like, you know when Angelina Jolie had a leg out and people made them have two legs? I'd do that. Yeah. Also, I don't approve of instruments not being played on stage. Thank you.
I fully agree with that. I understand that.
But you can't have that sax.
Don't have a real sax.
Hilarious. Like this whole staging behind this, the bouquet. So if you've not watched this, there are three girls on stage. They're all dressed as grooms, the women are dressed as brides, and the women have microphones that are hidden in bouquets of flowers that they're singing into, which is just superb.
Isn't it?
They have ridiculous leg dance routines. They all end up doing the running man at the end.
I think you're overselling it with ridiculous leg dance routines.
They're just stomping their feet
like horses.
I laughed out loud throughout most of that when I watched it earlier.
Yeah.
So
what we're moving on to now
is so next song up in the lineup is Iceland with Svala and Paper. We're not going to talk about this one. You, I think, are quite into it, yes?
It's another one. It's exactly like Poland's Flashlight. It's a dancey song I like to move my hips to, but...
Yeah, I'm not interested. I think it's a bit of a dud.
It's not
gonna
win.
Actually, I think it's more disappointing that they had the option of the wonderful Dorothy Freya Peterson with Is This Love?
Oh, God, yeah. Oh, my God.
That was a hot chip tune.
Yeah, that was
like,
a hot chip tune.
The fact that they had that as the choice and they went with Paper.
Yeah, you're right.
Nice try, no cigar.
Yeah. Bad times, Iceland. Moving on. After that, in fact, actually, we're in a reet line now.
Yeah.
We're not actually going to listen to another song for quite a while now. We're just going to speed through these ones. Next up after Iceland is Czech Republic with Martina Bata and My Turn. Rather a sweet song, but also I think it's going to get lost in the crowd of everything. Yeah. I can't remember it now off the top of my head. I can't even remember what Marta looks like.
Oh, no, that's bad.
So, dud. After that is Cyprus with Hovig and Gravity. Nothing new, nothing interesting. I'm not saying before anyone goes like about it, that any of these are particularly awful.
Yeah.
They are just not interesting songs. If you're going to come to Eurovision, bring something new, bring something interesting.
At least wear a headdress so you can
remember. Wear a headdress. That's all we ask for.
A feather or
and
two.
And also this one as well, in fact, was the one that it's sort of like Cyprus have got the memo a bit late about what people like and also done it a bit wrong.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of like they've badly copied Mons from 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And what's his name? Russia last year.
Yeah.
Sergei. From last year, but not done it quite as well. Right. After them, it's Armenia with Artsvig and Armenia.
From that road.
She lives next to Tamara.
I think I went to school with her daughter.
Blanche.
No, Deze. She's going out with William.
So the staging and outfits in the video for this, I haven't seen the live performance, but I've seen the video, is great. The song's goddamn awful though. You get halfway through, nothing's even happened. It got almost 2 minutes in and I was like, what's changed? Nothing's happening. I'm so bored.
Isabel's not saying any of these songs are bad apart from when she says
apart from
song
when I
bad.
Say they're bad. Armenia's one is bad. Soz, guys. But the staging and the outfits look great. Just dud song. Shit, next one.
Fair enough.
After that, I mean, is Slovenia, another boring one. Oh, Christ.
Yeah.
And then after that, it's Latvia.
It's a weak end to the semi-final, isn't it? It's a poor ending.
You can pretty much give up about halfway through
after
the first semi-final,
Mama.
Walk away, and by the time you have... I mean, you can go to the loo,
you can have a lasagna,
a cigarette, you can make a cup of tea, call your mum for that chat you haven't
had in
ages. Apply
for a credit card.
Yes.
Exactly. Get back. You still probably have three songs to suffer through.
Yeah.
So it's really bad. Anyone at the beginning, you've done really well.
Yeah.
Everyone at the end.
After Hey Mama, Sunstroke.
I've got no interest. Yeah, I'm putting it on mute and doing some other stuff for a while.
Got to admit, I've never watched a semi-final.
Oh my God.
I'm such a purist.
You're in for a treat,
oh God. Seriously, no, the semi-finals are the best because that's where the real duffers exist.
Mm.
That's where they get their time to shine.
That's why if you don't listen to them now, if things like, if Hey Mama didn't get through to the final, we'd have never heard
we'd never know it existed.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's the semis. I've flown through about six there that are crap.
Did we say Latvia? Latvia line.
Yeah, I didn't like it.
Okay, cool.
Done. Right, over. Yeah. Done. Boring. Yeah. So instead, we're going to talk about a couple of the big six that immediately get through to the finals.
Oh, yes.
So I thought, just to get it over and fucking done with, we'd discuss the permanent thorn in my side.
A gorilla man.
Fucking Francesco from Italy, Occidentalis Karma.
Let's have a look.
Let's literally get this over and done with. Storie dal gran finale, spera sì. Comunque vada pantarei. Singing in the rain. Lezioni di Nirvana, c'è butte in fila indiana. Per tutti un'ora d'aria di gloria. La folla grida un mantra, l'evoluzione inciampa. La scimmia nuda balla, occidentalis karma. Occidentalis karma, la scimmia nuda balla.
I didn't even see the gorilla.
Fuck, he's not on yet. Don't need to see the gorilla. The gorilla comes
he's
on.
He's got a
that
bad
fucking
voice.
Gorilla, that fucking dance.
Does nothing
like,
for me.
Namaste. Fuck right off. Can't stand it. He hasn't got a good voice. I'm so glad you've said that. He does not have a good voice.
I don't like listening to it.
It's just gravelly.
Yeah.
It's just gravelly. And everyone's interested because there's a fucking gorilla on stage. It's not good. If that was sung in English, when you look at what the lyrics are for that song, as we've discussed before, talking about like, oh, guys, put down your iPads and just all be like, voiced. Shut the fuck up. If that was sung in English, he would be laughed off the stage.
Yeah. Yeah.
There is no way that would do well if that was sung in English. Yeah. It was some white English guy singing that. Nah, no way.
Didn't you say that he's got like the most YouTube?
Yeah.
Like almost 7 million.
What a paradox. Put down your iPads, but make sure you watch my video.
Yeah, exactly. It's going to do well. It's already through to the finals. We know that. It's going to do well because of the big push behind it. It's going to get a lot from the public votes. I'm just hoping that the judges don't give it high votes either because I really don't want to see it in the top five.
He's just a poor man's Robbie, isn't he?
He is a poor man's Robbie, isn't he?
Yeah.
Fuck you.
As many are.
We'll move on. Let's move on. We're not giving it time of day.
So after this is Germany with Lavina, Perfect Life. I'm not afraid of making mistakes. Sometimes it's wrong.
It's one of the ones that we would have passed
like,
over.
Yeah, I'd have gone over that if it wasn't one of the big six.
Yeah.
But I mean, I ain't got much to say about that one.
No, it's a song.
Once again, makeup issues. Like, I'm a bit all or nothing about these kind of things. Like, either have no makeup at all and look beautiful in the way that God intended.
Yeah.
Or good slap.
Because Aminata, again, going back to Lovely Love Injected.
Yeah.
Very little makeup. but absolutely the styling was still on point. It wasn't needed, but I know what you mean. It just
she's
looks
just got
a bit
a pair
like
of car
you
doors.
Haven't done it properly.
Yeah.
So final song of the night,
yeah.
And this is a host nation, the Ukraine. So this is now, we're going to show you a little bit of the absolute train wreck that is
Oh, no.
Torvald with Time.
Ukraine
do not want to win a second year.
Right.
You will realize there's no common ground, there's no compromise between time and sound. Time to look, time to see, time to fight.
Oh, what a pile of shit. It's like a bad Muse song done by a teenage tribute
idiot.
Band.
A teenage idiot.
Top tip to anyone ever doing a performance, which I learned this year, which is never have anything that denotes how long your performance will be, such as something going backwards. Say if you had like, you're like, we're going to do the story of the seven blah, blah, blah. And,
yeah.
And you get through three and they're an identical length. Then everyone knows, fuck, I've got four more to go and I know exactly how long
yeah.
they're going to be.
Yeah.
Or if you have pages, people can see. Because if it's not that good,
yeah.
people will get bored.
Yeah. Having clocks on your, like the one, like you said during it, Benj, the one sort of decent thing is that they've got a bit of makeup where it looks like they've got clocks in their chest.
Spectacular prosthetics.
But that in itself means that you're waiting for the song to end because you're
just
counting down.
Just constantly counting down. Also, with them, like, God, I've got 30 seconds left.
Also, one of the three guitarists' clocks broke halfway through, so you've got to fix that for the actual
But also, like, if you are going to do countdown, like, do something clever like that where it, like, you're like, oh, it's going down a different time. And then for some reason, that person explodes.
Well,
do you know what I mean? Like, play with expectations.
Add some magic.
All right, yeah, add some magic. Or I thought, like, it would hit zero maybe, like, 30 seconds before the end and that would be a huge, like, break where it would all, like, kick off. The end of the song was when it hit zero and then it was
starts
like,
counting back up again, for fuck's sake. It's like it's never ending. Just stuck in this hellhole of terrible, dull rock.
So that's kind of, that's all of the songs that we've covered from the first semi-final and the first three national entry, like Big Six.
So we're going to do the same again next week?
Yeah, we are. Before we end, though, we've got a treat, right?
Oh, fuck, yeah, we've got a treat. Benji has our first ever Eurovision entry from not Roland.
Yeah, and before I came, I kind of did some vocals and they were awful, and then I decided that I would do it live here, and now I've had three glasses of wine, so this is going to be
wine helps,
quite
right? Wine
exciting.
Helps. Great. Do you have the USB stick?
Yeah, I do.
Give it to me. So, Benj, do you want to talk us through the song, what it's about and what your motivations are behind it?
Well, so I've written this song. It's called We Are the Future, brackets, We Are One, brackets. I have written it and co-produced it with my friend Ollie. We are called Two Spicy Legends as a producing act. And I just think that I have it in me to write a Eurovision winner. And
yeah.
I think if it were possible to be part of that process, that I could really go somewhere with this song.
This is very exciting. So so this is your song. Say the title one more time.
We Are the Future, brackets, We Are One, brackets.
Here we go.
Your mother said, hush now, little one, don't you cry. And your father said, play by the rules, child, don't be wild. But you've grown now, come on and sing it loud, stand up and be proud. Because you've got to let them know, no, no, you're ready to go, go. You've got to let them know, no, no, you're ready to go, go. Yes, you've got to let them know, no, no, you're ready to go, go. You've got to let them know, no, no, you're ready to go, go. Your teacher said, Do this, do that, sit down, stand up. And your lover said, you'll never make it, don't you even try. But you'll show them all, come on now, stand up tall. Let out your battle call and baby let them know, no, no. You're ready to go, go. Yeah, you've got to let them know, no, no. You're ready to go, go. We are the future, we are one. Yes, we are the future, we are one. We are the future, we are one. Yes, we are the future, we are one. And it's our time, yes, yours and mine. Open your eyes and let's take to the skies. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. Yes, we are the future, we are one. We are the future, we are one. Yes, we are the future, we are one. And you've got to let them know, no, no, that you're ready to go, go. Yeah, you've got to let them know. Yes, we are one.
Yeah!
That was bloody fantastic. That was amazing.
Okay, I'm gonna do this as we discussed. I'm gonna do this the same way I do Roland. So lyrically, yep, on point with Eurovision.
Yeah.
You're bringing everyone together. You're combining. You know, we're all joining hands across different continents with that song.
And in these political times as well, it's all about
we
you know being
that.
Yourself and not taking the establishment's word for
fuck
the
man. Exactly.
Damn the man.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, lyrics, music, tune, all of it. Like, I'd have a reet dance to that in a club.
Yeah.
My one note is I think that it could be in the We Are One bits, I think it could go more. I think it could go bigger. There needs to be more of like a, I don't know, drums behind it or something. Mm. It could be.
There's often
kids
like
choir.
Kids choir, yeah. There's like, there is a particular type of, there's a particular type of big drum that quite a lot of Eurovision songs use that is, and you could, like, they it's in that joke song, Love, Peace, Peace, Love, Love,
that
they did in Sweden, where they had a topless man banging a drum. And I think a topless man banging a drum would be great to add as an addition. And that's staging as well, but there's a little bit of sound that could add there that just adds an extra level of emotion. I thought it was fantastic though.
Thank
I thought
you.
It really reached some real highs and it was dramatic and beautiful. but I think
so serious,
I do agree with Isobel, and it's the same the vast majority of my songs and the vast majority of Eurovision songs is there's always like, oh, I wish it went one step higher.
But
that's the thing. I think it's different to your ones. I think yours are, as Xanthony said, yours are normally overproduced, far too overproduced, whereas I think that could be a little bit
so maybe a bit higher produced. But also I think you're right, like a choir or some extra voices, and you were doing it live, so that's not like, you know, me and Isobel hadn't been told, you know, if we could sing backing or not. We didn't.
In future, I will get you involved in singing the We Are the Future.
But as a, you know, as I always say, all of mine are sketches, and as a sketch is more than 90% of the way there. You just need to add some.
And in terms of performance, I thought I'd go for like a Sia vibe, whereby I'd be kind of stood, you know, just kind of doing my thing, and I'd have like a little kid. Like dancing around. So you know, like with like your mother said, I'll be like singing
nice.
To them, and then like it changes and it's obvious it's me that's the grown-up, like,
yeah,
the kids,
yeah,
which I think it'd be a beautiful performance.
I'm just very happy that we've had our first Eurovision entry that isn't written
me
by me
too.
It's very it's quite refreshing to hear someone's voice
more
that isn't
of
mine.
Them please, if you've got any out there, please email us europhoriapodcast@gmail.com.
yeah,
we've had the first song now and we're gonna give it our first judging.
Yeah.
Oh
god, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, Isobel, this is up to you. I'm not gonna give it a score. This is still your domain.
Oh.
Remember where your bread's buttered.
Right, so I would say I'm gonna give that a high dies.
Ooh!
A high dies.
I was in my head.
What?
In my head, I was like, anything less than a dies and like, you're dead to me.
I'm fully aware of that. It wouldn't be that harsh anyway. No, that's not just me. That's not just nepotism.
No.
That is
good song.
Pure talent. That that's a high dies. That would easily get to an uns with just a little bit extra in the background. Yeah. And just a little bit.
And that was live as
I
well.
I think I could probably, yeah, exactly. That was, I mean.
And on Dory Riocas.
That might. Come back. We're going to come back to that finished product when you've got that all recorded, when you've got the vocals how you want them.
Yeah.
We'll have another listen then.
That's great.
So, Benji, where are we going to see you next as a podcast and your that rabble you keep around you, including portion of fries?
Well, let me tell you. If you're free on May 13th, which just happens to be the evening of the Eurovision Song Contest, get yourself down to the Montague Arms in Peckham, where you can find your friend and mine, Portion of Fries, hosting a wonderful Eurovision event with Isobel and Roland from the podcast.
Oh, fucking yeah.
It's going to be a hella good time.
I just got some prizes for the raffle.
Oh.
So there's going to be the 1999 Eurovision annual.
Amazing.
Dana International Diva on CD single.
Amazing.
Ooh.
Gina G. Ooh, are just a little bit on
wow.
CD single.
Ooh.
And Javine Touch My Fire on CD single.
I want that one.
And there's going to be badges. It's going to be an absolute delight.
It's going to be great fun. The whole place is hired out for Eurovision.
Yeah.
So it's just going to be jam packed full of other Eurovision fans.
Yeah.
So if you've not got anything else on that evening, or if you're going to go to some like someone's was going to do a party,
like,
but they're kind of only doing
yeah.
it because they want to do a party, but actually they're not going to watch Eurovision, and actually they're not going to know what's going on. They're going to question things all the time. Sack those people off. They're not your friends. We're your friends. Come and see us in the Montague Arms in Peckham. You can buy tickets online. It's nil point, or as spelled, if you don't know what you're searching for on Facebook, nil points, like nil points. A Eurovision screening. You can buy tickets online. So the first 50 tickets are going to be in the main room with the big screen.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But there's the whole pub is hired out, so anything after that, you'll be in the rest of it. There's still be TV screens and stuff. You can go to watch Eurovision, have a great time.
It's gonna be great.
But buy those tickets because they're more expensive on the door on the evening.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So that's it then. Benj, thanks so much for coming in.
It was
really great having you and having your judgment on some of these songs. We're going to be back next week. Benj is very busy, so sadly can't
songs,
join us.
Benj.
But we're going to be back next week, and we're going to do the second part of the semi-finals, and it'll be out on the morning of the semi-finals. So be sure to listen that morning.
Just have enough time.
Yeah.
It's less than 2 weeks away.
I know, it's crazy.
When the podcast goes out, it'll be a week and a half.
That's so exciting.
Yeah,
like some people go for Christmas, not me.
No. Eurovision.
Less heartache at Eurovision.
Three most important times of the year: Eurovision, Pride, Sink the Print Christmas Ball.
Yeah.
That's the only three. That's how I measure the year.
Yeah, me too. What are we like, eh? Right there.
On that note, let's end the podcast in the same way we end every single podcast. In the words of Slavko, Isobel, the spaceship is ready to blow. I'm drunk in love. Are you going to explode?
About Robin, not about you. Sorry, we're just friends. Like, I know that you might be thinking more of that.
Okay. Oh, well, on that note, thank you all for listening. And from all of us here, goodbye.
Bye.